I'm going to share with you my experience about the new technology of Exufiber has to clean the wound bed. And this is a really challenge in clinical practice because, as you can see in this image, you have a dry wound. But after you start debridement, and it's important to do debridement and prepare the wound bed, you need to use a dressing that will help you and promote the autolytic debridement. That's when I started to use the Exufiber and then the flex on the top that will help me to have the moist environment healing that I need to do an autolytic debridement. And you see quite well that after cleaning the wound bed, you have a different wound surface. And it's important. You can see quite well here that when you remove the first dressing, you see on the bottom a large amount of exudation. And you see quite well the Exufiber getting out from the wound. But you can see quite well that perhaps you may think that you have an infection or something, but what you have is autolytic debridement. The wound bed completely changed, and you see there's wet tissue inside that will be easy remove if you use a gauze or something to clean without causing any pain to the patient, or if you use a scalpel or forceps to remove and then to cut the dead tissue that you have inside. Of course, here you are just cleaning the wound, and then after cleaning this, you have a huge cavity, of course, because you debride it, but you can apply next to this in the cavity the Exufiber. What is going to do? Absorb, retain, and transfer to the secondary dressing. But in the middle of this, what is going to do is create or promote an autolytic debridement that will help you to reduce the amount of dead tissues on that wound. And of course, if you can control the moist environment, if you can control there's no maceration around the wound, what is going to happen? Growth of tissues from the bottom to the top, and then the borders of the wound will start to contract, and obviously you'll have better healing rates. In this situation that you can see here, from 1 month to the other, we reduce the time of, or the number of times that we made dressing changes. You can see here after the second month, you can see quite well there's a huge reduction on the wound size, and of course you see that's really healthy tissue on the bottom. And after each treatment, we were able to clean, we were able to see if there's need to debride anything, but more important of this, you create the moist environment needed to heal. And here you can see on this last month, you can see the evolution, the contraction, and even the epithelialization of the tissue. And of course, in the third month, you see there's a small wound, nothing compared with the beginning. And you'll see on the fourth month, you have completely healed the wound. That's why it's important to maintain humidity, the moist environment, but simultaneously use the capacities of the Exufiber to absorb, retain, and transfer to the secondary dressing. Sometimes we need to evaluate how other materials perform. And some situations are really difficult because you have huge, highly exudated wounds and you need to prepare the wound bed. And some materials, they are really good absorbing and retaining the exudation. But the problem is the contact layers in the tissues, they don't change really the wound bed surface. That's why you see in some situations, in some clinical cases, that it absorbs, it retains there the leakage, but the problem is with gravity, with the amount of exudation, you start to have leakage and also transforms the exudation status. And in situations like this, you see you have a huge amount of more viscous exudation that the dressing used there was not able to absorb and then transfer to the secondary dressing. And of course, there's a risk of maceration and decrease of healing rates. That's been a great experience for me and for my team when we started to use the Exufiber. That's why I will continue to use, because I have a product that, or a technology that helps me to control the amount of exudation, helps me to transfer the fluids in a cavity to a secondary dressing, simultaneously gives me the moist environment that I need to promote autolytic debridement, and in the end, if I use the AG technology, I have the capacity to simultaneously deliver silver ions in the wound bed and try to promote or protect against the biofilm formation in the window of opportunity. Thank you very much for your time.